you say to the communities that are affected in and around Staffordshire?
Well, look, I am the first to accept that when you do any big major infrastructure, you can't do it without sort of someone who's interfaced with as far as local communities are concerned. But this has actually been, I think, what's happened here has been a test case for the way in which the contractors, the alliance, coming together, four different companies coming together, acting as one company to deliver this particular project, have worked with the local residents and have taken them through what happened. But of course, I accept that, you know, a big railway project like HS2 is going to cause controversy. Having said that, I've just come past the eyes of Wilton Cottage to see where the West Coast main line was taken. Now, you know, those things have to happen. If we're going to have the connectivity between our main cities that we desperately need to have to ensure those cities have the opportunity of attracting investment, allowing people to travel, giving more local services as well, that, you know, the idea that you get this extra capacity and somehow you don't then make use of the rest of the capacity is something that is not going to happen.
You've pledged to work with communities affected by HS2. How exactly is the government planning to do that?
Well, there's a big engagement. The first proposals that we're talking through at the moment, what was given the second reading the third reading last week by the House of Commons, was from London to Birmingham, basically then up to Handsacre, so it just stops at Handsacre. We will be taking another bill forward to Parliament, which will deal with Handsacre up to Crewe, which will mean that you get all that benefit to the northwest a bit sooner. So that work is starting, and that consultation and that engagement exercise will be starting in the very near future.
And the people who are going to continue to battle against this, what message do you have for them?
Well, look, there will always be people who will oppose any kind of new building. That is simple and straightforward. You know, we can't. I believe it is in the national interest that we have HS2. We can't, you know, if somebody is directly affected, we've got to compensate them, we've got to do that. But actually, we've also got to look at what is the transport system for this country for the next 100 years, not the next 10 or 20 years.
Thank you. I'd just like to ask you one more question about the M6 toll as well, if that's possible. Operation Freeway, that's due to be renewed, I think it's today, in fact, or tomorrow, isn't it? Is that going to come into force again?
Well, we will always look at what contingency measures we can have, and the continuation of where there is a major disruption, the alternative being used is something we want to look at, and we'll facilitate that contract that we had in the past again.